When we talk about the principal being the tone setter of the building, a colleague comes to mind, and I think about how much work she did to become trusted within the Somali community, working with elders, helping them understand why her school was a good school for them to come to, how they could work together to educate children. And she set a tone for her teachers. She wrote a grant and actually went to the camps in Kenya to see what were the conditions that the students were living in before they came to her, because she was a newcomer site. So one day they're in Kenya, then they're on the plane, and basically the next day they're in her school. That's a humongous transition. She could come back and talk to her staff about the resilience of these kids, what a transformation in their environment. And that helped change the way teachers saw kids coming into the building. So you can look at a child and go, wow, you know, yesterday their life was totally different. Today they're in this building. How can I make them feel comfortable? How can I help them get accustomed to the routines that we're going to have in this school? And I'm reminded of a situation. This happened not too long after 9/11, so everybody's kind of on edge. And a teacher saw a student with a very sharp object, called the principal, and this was a child who had only maybe been in the school less than a week. And the principal saw this sharp top of a can and some string, looked very unusual to the teacher, but the principal recognized it as a toy she had actually seen in the camps. You don't have a lot. Kids are creative. You know, they come up with ways to make toys, to be entertained. And so this was not a weapon. It was not something to hurt anybody else. It was just a toy. If you don't have some cultural openness, you can't see things always for what they are, and you interpret them only through your own lens. And that could have taken a really negative track for that child and for that teacher. So I know not everyone can go to the camps where their kids are coming from or see the experiences that their students have had. But to be open to that, to ask questions, to talk to family members, to talk to community members, to start to really open and broaden your own horizons about what life is like for your kids.